warm welcome to online class of Nagesh Karasgi Orchid School. Good morning to everyone. I congratulate and welcome to all my dear students for this new module of learning experience. As we all know, this pandemic has brought us to the new concept of social distancing. So we will be continuing our online education. I, Ms. Nehal Mane, will be teaching you class 6 mathematics. I hope you all are fit, fine, healthy and safe at home. I also know you must be helping your parents, playing, studying and eating a variety of food and taking precautions. So let us start with our first lesson, knowing our numbers. Before starting the lesson, I would like to ask you one question. Can you tell me what language does the computer speaks? Do anyone of you know? Yes, very good. Computer speaks binary language. Now, what does mean by binary language? Can anyone of you tell what does it consist of? What we see in binary language? No one? Okay, let me tell you. Binary language consists of two numbers. Only two numbers. Those are 0 and 1. A beautiful language which is the combination of only two numbers 0 and 1 is called as the binary language. So, in this lesson we are going to see more about the numbers. What is a number? A number is a mathematical value which is helped or used for counting and measuring different objects. We use numbers in day-to-day activities. Numbers are all around us. Numbers are helpful for carrying out many operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So, we are going to learn more about numbers in this new lesson. So, our first topic is knowing our numbers. In this lesson, we are going to learn about greatest and smallest numbers, comparing numbers, order of numbers, shifting the digits, Indian number system, international number system, estimation, brackets and Roman numerals. Numbers. What are numbers? Why do we use numbers? Can anyone of you tell me? Yes, numbers are used for counting. What do we use numbers for? Counting. Only counting? No. Still many things are there. Can anyone of you tell me? Yes, we can find the greatest and smallest numbers. We can also measure different objects. So, there are main uses are, numbers are helpful for counting. We find the greatest and smallest number and we measure the different objects. So, there are two main purposes of numbers. What are those? The first one is counting. Numbers are used for counting. Now it is said natural numbers. What does mean by natural numbers? The numbers which are mostly used for counting are called as natural numbers. The smallest natural number is 0 and there is no such greatest natural number because as we go on, the numbers are increasing. See students, on this image, we can see image of bags. Can you tell me how many bags are there? How many bags? 6. Very good. How do you know there are 6 bags? What did you done? Yes, you have counted. What you have counted? The objects, the bags. You have counted the objects. Next purpose is ordering. Now what does mean by ordering? See, you can see image of India. What is India? Here stands for ordering. See, as we know, India is the 7th largest country in the world. So 7th is the number which we use for ordering. Let us take one more example. China is the mostly populated country in the world. In the same way, India is the second most populated country in the world. So, there are main two purposes of numbers. One is for counting and other is for ordering. Let us see the next slide, comparing the numbers. Now, less than symbol is used to find whether the quantity is less than or small than the other quantity. Now, in this example, you can see 453 is greater than 236. So, we use the less than symbol. Next, greater than symbol is used to show the greater quantity. Like 78 is greater than 32. The other quantity is greater. Now, when the left hand side and right hand side, the numbers or the quantities are equal, then we show the equal to symbol. If the numbers are equalized on both the sides. Now, if the numbers are not equal, that means on the left hand side the quantity is different and on the right hand side the quantity is different, then we show the not equal to symbol. Let us see one video.
Comparing numbers. In this module, you will learn to compare numbers. Look at these numbers. Which is the greatest number among them? It is 59,785. You can see that 59,785 has the maximum number of digits compared to other numbers. This helps us to generalize that the number having maximum number of digits is the greatest number. Now look at these numbers. Since both the numbers have the same number of digits, it is difficult to find the greater number between them using the previous method. In such a case, we look at the digit at the highest place value, which is thousands in the case of the given numbers. Since 6 is greater than 4 at the thousands place, 6,895 is greater than 4,875. Next, the two remaining numbers have equal number of digits, that is 4. Compare the leftmost digits of the two numbers, that is the digit at thousands place. The digit at thousands place of both the numbers is same. That is 6. Now we need to see the digits at right of the thousands place, that is digits at hundreds place. Since 9 is greater than 4, 6969 is greatest among all the given numbers. In this module, you have learned that if you are given two numbers, the number with more digits is greater. If you are given two numbers, the number with less digits is smaller. If number of digits in two given numbers is same, the number having greater leftmost digit is greater. If the leftmost digit is same, you look at the next digit to its right and follow the same method to find the greater number.
Now, we have seen about the comparing numbers of 3 digits and 2 digits. Now, let us learn about the finding greatest and smallest number with different digits. See the example. We have few examples. Numbers like 2383, 25,783, 4,682, 184, 72 and 440. Now we have to find the greatest number as well as the smallest number. Now how to compare these numbers? When we have less digits. Now from these many numbers, which number is having less digit? 72, very good. And which number is having the greatest digits? 25. 25,783. So the greatest number is 25,783, whereas the smallest number is 72. So what we have learnt? Numbers can be compared by comparing the numbers in it. Numbers with less number of digits is lesser than the number with more number of digits. Let us compare the numbers with same digits. Example, now we have the example three numbers with same digits, means all the examples are of four digits. 4,192, 5,630, 9,200. We have to find the greatest number as well as the smallest number. Now, as these are four digits, so we have to compare the leftmost digit from each the number. The first digit is 4, here the first digit is 5, and here the first digit is 9. So, among these, which is the greatest? Yes, 9. So, the greatest number is 9,200. Now, we have to find the smallest number. Now, as this is done, we have to compare 4 and 5, which is the leftmost digit from the both numbers. So, here it is 4 and here it is 5. Which is the smallest among these? Yes, very good. It's 4,192. So, smallest number is 4,192. So, numbers can be compared by comparing the leftmost number in it and the numbers of same digit then. Numbers with less number of digits is lesser than the number with more number of digits. Now you can see the image, children. See, there are five children here: Riya, Saurabh, Seema, Sam and Karthik. So these children are having different heights. One is of 153 cm, 154 cm, Seema is 160 cm, Sam is 140 cm, and Karthik is 164 cm. Now, can you find who is having the greatest height or who is the tallest one? Any one of you? Yes, very good. It's Karthik. Karthik is having the greatest height. His height is 164 cm. And who is having the smallest height? Who is the shortest person? Yes, it's Sam. Sam is the shortest one. His height is 140 cm. How did you compare, students? As all are of three digits and all are having one in its leftmost place, so we have compared the second digit. So when we compared second digit, Karthik is the tallest one and Sam is the shortest one. Order of numbers. Do you know how many orders are there in numbers? Yes, two numbers. Let us see those. Ascending order. What does mean by ascending order? Arrangement of numbers from smallest to greatest. And what does mean by descending order? Arrangement of numbers from greatest to smallest. These are two orders. Let us solve few examples for ascending order and descending order. See here, arrange the following in ascending order. Few numbers are given, like 567, 34, 23,445, 781, 4,897. So, we have to arrange this in ascending order. Now, what does ascending order mean? Just now we have seen. Yes, it starts from smallest to greatest. So, which is the smallest one here? With less digit? Yes, it's 34. Afterwards, we have 567. Then we have 781. Then 4 digit 4,897. Then 5 digit 23,445. So this is the ascending order that starts from smallest and goes to greatest. Next question, arrange the following in descending order. Again, few examples are given: 123, 222, 546, 265, 160, and 189. Now we have 6 different numbers, but these numbers are of same digits, which are of 3 digits. Now we have to compare this and go into descending order. What does mean by descending order? It starts from greatest to smallest. So what is the greatest among these? Yes, it's 546. After that, 265. After that, 222. After that, 189. Then 160. Then 123. So this is the descending order that starts from greatest to smallest. Now let us learn few rules of comparing the numbers. Rule 1. The number with less digit is less than the number with more digit. Now in this example we can see the left hand side we have number 45, which is of 2 digits. And on the right hand side we have the number 567, which is of 3 digits. So one is of 2 digit and one is of 3 digit. Which is the less one? Yes, 45, because it is having the less digit. So the number is less. Next rule. Suppose we have to compare two numbers having the same number of digits when we proceed as follows. See here. First compare the digits at the leftmost place in both the numbers. Now we have 782, which is of 3 digits on the left hand side, and 456 on the right hand side, which is again of 3 digits. Now we have to compare these digits. So from the leftmost place we have to see the first number. Here it's 7 and here it's 4. So which is the greater one? Yes, 700. So 782 is greater than 456. Let us see the step 2. If they are equal in value, then compare the second digit from the left. Now, in last example, we have seen the first digit are same. Now, we have to compare the second digit when the first digits are same. Now, when we compare, here it's 0 and here it's 2. So, which is the greater? 2. So, 326 is greater. Step 3, if the second digit from the left are equal, then compare the third digit. Now see, now this is a 4 digit number on both the hand sides. One is of 9852 and other is 9834. From the left hand side, the first digit is 9, both are equal. Let us go to the second digit. Second digit is 8, both are equal. Let us go to the third digit. Third digit, here it's 5 and here it's 3. Now we have to compare this. Which is the greater one? Yes, it's 5. So the number 9852 is greater than 9834. Step 4. How much you will continue till you get the answer? So we have to continue till you come across an unequal digits, then the number with greater digits is greater. For example, 56,796 and 56,792. It is the greater number, which is having 5 digits. So we have compared first, it is same. Second also it is same. Third also it is same. Fourth also it is same. So let us go to fifth digit, that is here it's 6 and here it's 2. So which is the greater? 6. So 56,796 is the greater number. Let us go to the next slide. Shifting the digits. Shifting means shifting the place value of the given digits. Now see, in this example we have the number 5693. Now it is said to shift 5 in the place of 9 and 9 in the place of 5. In terms of place value, we have to shift 10th place to 1000th place and 1000th place to 10th place. So after shifting, we form the new number called as 9653. Now, what does mean by shifting of digits? Shifting or interchanging the given number from one place to the other to form or to get a new number, it's called as shifting of digits. Let us see few more examples. Interchange first and second digit of the given numbers. Now see, we have the number 8930. Now we have to interchange this first and second digit. The first digit is 8 and the second digit is 9. After interchanging, we get the number. Can anyone of you tell? Yes, very good. It's 9830. We have interchanged thousands place and hundreds place and we got the new number 9830. Let us go to the next example. Interchange first and last digit of the given number 5409. Now we have to interchange the first digit and the last digit. So the new number formed is 9405. So we have interchanged again the ones place and thousands place. And the number formed is 9405. Let us do an activity. How many numbers can you make? Find the greatest and smallest number also. Now, few digits are given. Without repeating the digits, 4, 5 and 7 form different 3-digit number. See, only 3 digits we are having and we should not repeat the digits, but we have to form a new number. We have to find new how many numbers. Let us see here. The first number is 457. Yes. The next number is 475. The next number is 547. Then 574. Then 745. And then 754. Okay, so we have formed new numbers without repeating the digits. How many numbers are these? These are 6 numbers. These are 6 numbers. Okay, so which is the smallest from here? Yes, it's 457 is the smallest number. And which is the greatest? Yes, it's 754 is the greatest number. And how many digits we have formed? We obtained 6 3 digits new numbers from only 4, 5 and 7. Let us go towards next example. Expansion of numbers. Expand the following number. The following number is of 6 digits. To expand the given following number, we have to first find the place values of the given number. So, ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands and lakhs are the place values. Let us keep these given numbers in those place values. At ones place, we have 5. At tens place, we have 8. At hundreds place, we have 4. At thousands place, we have 6. At 10,000s place, we have 3. And at lakhs place, we have 7. So this is a 6-digit number. We have arranged it according to its place values. Now we have to expand the following number. Now see here, as 7, it is in lakhs place, so 7 is multiplied by lakh, 1 lakh. Then next, 3 is in 10,000's place, so 3 is multiplied by 10,000. 6 is in thousands place, so 6 is multiplied by 1000. 4 is in hundreds place, so 4 is multiplied by 100. 8 is in tens place, so 8 is multiplied by tens. And ones we have to keep as it is 5. So 7 multiplied by lakh, 7 lakh. 3 multiplied by 10,000, 30,000. 6 multiplied by 1000, 6,000. 4 multiplied by 100, 400. 8 multiplied by 10, 18. And 5 as it is. So we have expanded the following number: 7,36,485. The expansion of the following number is given below. Let us see about large numbers now. The greatest one digit number is 9. When we add 1 to greatest one digit number, we get smallest two digit number 10. The greatest two digit number is 99. When we add 1 to 99, we get 100, that is smallest three digit number. Greatest three digit number is 999. When we add 1 to 999, we get 1000, that is smallest four digit number. Greatest four digit number is 9999. When we add 1 to it, we get 10,000, that is smallest five digit number. Greatest 5 digit number is 99,999. When we add 1 to it, we get 1 lakh, that is smallest 6 digit number. Greatest 6 digit number is 9,99,999. When we add 1 to it, we get 10 lakh, that is smallest 7 digit number. When we add, the greatest 7 digit number is 99,99,999. When we add 1 to it, we get 1 crore, that is the smallest 8 digit number. Next, we will solve one more example of expansion. 70,64,523. 7 is in 10 lakhs place, so it is multiplied by 10 lakh. 0 we will keep as it is. 6 is in 10 thousands place, so it is multiplied by 10,000. 4 is in thousands place, so we multiplied it by 1000. 5 is in hundreds place, so we multiply it by 100. 2 is in tens place, so we multiply it by 10. And 3 is in ones place, so keep as it is. So 70 lakh plus 60,000 plus 4000 plus 500 plus 20 plus 3 is the expansion of the following number: 70,64,523. I hope you understood the concept. If you have any doubts, you can free to ask. Thank you so much, and I request all the students to solve, try these sums from your textbooks. Thank you, everyone.